Hi team, I'm about to introduce you to a song from Movement to Music that I used to listen to when I was younger. Now, this song is the Top Gun anthem off a very famous movie, but I used to listen to it to help me focus when I was competing in track and field. Now, a lot of people think that movement and music are just to do with dancing, but I used to listen to this song while I was warming up before I competed. The warm-ups were very rhythmic and they sort of involved things like skipping and jumping and leaping. So I really liked this song because it got me really excited, but it also kept me in time with my warm-up. So this is another way that you can incorporate music and how it can impact the way that we move. I hope you like the song, and I've got a short clip of when I was competing as well. And it's a really cool upbeat song with a really cool guitar. Really, really cool. I hope you like it.
He will be hoping to deprive a Matthew Coad, who's been the informed sprinter this summer, in the absence of Chris Donaldson. And it's great to see Matthew Coad, who will run in lane number three, back to somewhere where he was 4 or 5 years ago. Those days, he really looked to be every bit as talented as Chris Donaldson. Just hasn't kicked on, had injury problems, but this summer he's back with a vengeance, and how he would love to claim this senior title. No Chris Donaldson, of course, who's still out with that Achilles tendon problem that shattered his hopes and dreams at the Sydney Olympics a few months back. And Gustin Keisha, former national champion as well. And Keisha running in lane number four, Coad in three. Two fastest in this race. Big tailwind behind them as well. This should be a pretty fast time. And out well is the big frame there of Matthew Coad, the smaller figure of Gustin Keisha, and coming through alongside of them as well as Lachie McClellan. But Coad, the big man, he's a very big man, got a lot of upper body bulk, and he really did hammer it out hard over those last 50 metres. 10.23 unofficially, big tailwind. That's the fastest 100 metres, legal or illegal, as it were, that Matthew Coad, I'm sure, has ever run in his life. But more importantly, the smile on his face. And we haven't seen much of Matthew Coad smiling in recent times, but he's back with a vengeance.
Keisha got off to a very good start. He's very fast out of the block. Probably more experience than Coad, but Coad on the right-hand side is really starting to pump those muscles now, and he comes flying through in the last 20 metres of his race. Is the best part of it, the winning one.
Yes, he's a big man. He likes the 200 metres, but he was very much in his zone there over the last few metres. As we look again, John Walker saying the smaller figure there of Gustin Keisha getting a better start, and Coad at this stage really only in about third place behind McClellan as well. But now, look at the strength and the power. He hit another gear, and that carried him to victory.